Now, this game is vital for Chelsea's title hopes, and Spurs will not give up their European dream easily. Ancelotti has some tough decisions to make, so who and what formation will he play, Jason?
4-3-3, Didier Drogba.
Not that tough then, is it?
No, it's not tough.
Straight out of the bag there.
Yeah. Yep.
Would you go along with that?
100%. I mean, listen, Fernando Torres has scored his first goal, and everyone, all the Chelsea fans are absolutely delighted. Maybe Liverpool fans aren't. But Didier Drogba's on fire at the moment. And Carlo Ancelotti has just got to think, listen, I've got to finish on a high. They're still in with half a chance if somehow Arsenal actually get a decent result at the Emirates against Manchester United. You know, and Chelsea go on and win every single game. You never know what can happen. But just the important thing is to finish on a high. It's taken him, since Torres has come in, to realise that 4-4-2 at Chelsea does not work with the players they have. They work better with 4-3-3. It's Drogba or Torres, and at the moment Drogba's playing better.
This is all about Chelsea, this game. Chelsea don't want to play this game and find out that Manchester United drop point. Chelsea get beat by Spurs at drop points, and then Arsenal beat Manchester United, they would be...
They don't like playing against Spurs, though, do they, Chelsea?
Yeah, this is
traditionally the Chelsea's derby, isn't it, of the season?
The biggest game. It's probably bigger for Chelsea as Spurs. Spurs' derby is against Arsenal.
Yeah,
but I mean, anyway.
But for Chelsea, Spurs.
But it's a big game for Spurs as well. Make no doubt about that.
Well, what does Harry have to do? Who's his weapon of mass destruction in this game?
Well, they've had problems scoring goals. I think that may well have been his problem that in training transfer. They didn't strengthen up front. You know, Crouch and Defoe. Defoe's been in a wretched run of form. Scored a fantastic goal against West Brom last weekend. They haven't scored enough goals. Van der Vaart has been their secret weapon of mass destruction, if you want to say. Bale on the left-hand side as well. For me, Spurs' season is ground to a very disappointing halt. Getting knocked out of the Champions League, they're not going to finish fourth.
You know what they've been doing?
They've been concentrating
too much on the Champions League. I think some of the players have been thinking, isn't this run absolutely fantastic? And the bread and butter games where they've dropped too many points. You know, they've got a game in hand, but that game in hand is against Manchester City.
Yeah.
So before you know
it... So complacency is a problem and taking their eye off the ball.
Complacency, yeah. I think they've definitely taken their eye off the ball.
They're 2-1 up against West Brom at White Hart Lane, and they dropped that point. No disrespect to West Brom, they should be seeing that game out. And there's been a couple of times this season.
There's been more than a couple. Yeah. You look at the lower eight sides, and you go through Tottenham's games. They've dropped too many points where you say, if you want to finish in the top four, you quite simply have to win those games, and they've not been doing that. And now there's too much of a gap, because City can drop points, but it's going to be tough for them to catch it up.
Head-to-head, Lampard versus Van der Vaart, who's going to come out on top?
I'd go for Lampard, Frank Lampard.
Lamps.
He's got the experience.
Lamps or Vaart?
Lamps.
Lamps?
Yeah.
Anyone in the crowd going for Vaart on this one? Madam, if next time if you can shout yes, because I don't think we can really see the hand going up, and it's not too loud either, so next time. Anyone going for Van der Vaart on this one?
Yes.
Okay, but do shout it next time, madam. Scott, you're going to go first. You have 10 seconds to try and get your score spot on.
Okay, yeah, I mean, this is going to be a tough one to call, but I think Chelsea at home have been, or Chelsea anyway in the last couple of months, have been on fire in the league, and I think they will be too strong for a Spurs side that are tiring. Chelsea 2, Spurs 0.
Interesting, but...
Sorry.
No, but they do seem to be tiring. Jason, you have just 10 seconds to try and get your score spot on.
Well, traditionally this was a game that Chelsea had no problems going into. In recent years, Spurs have come back into it, but Stamford Bridge has always been an unhappy hunting ground for them. It's going to continue. Chelsea are going to win this one. Chelsea 3, Spurs 1.
Let's see where the Facebookers
shook
playing.
Your head at me, and yeah. What about that?
Yeah, come on. Scott Minto was not a party to that, madam.
Three goals.
Yeah, that's... Come on, don't blame the Minto. But do blame him for a terrible defensive error for Benfica a few seasons ago. Sorry, Sporting Lisbon fans. Let's see. He only did one mistake in all the... How many years at Benfica?
There for about a day.
1 year. 2 years? 3 years?
Yeah.
One mistake. Let's see whether the Facebookers playing online agree with our pundits. You, the crowd, are saying Chelsea 2, Tottenham 1. And that settles the score for Chelsea versus Tottenham Hotspur.